Well, this week, Governor Gavin Newsom issued new guidelines to help children with special needs get back to the classroom. Tonight, 23 ABC's Tori Cooper is joining us live from Central Bakersfield, where she spoke to a parent of a special needs student who's been struggling through distance learning. She explains the guidance released this week and how it's aimed to support students with special needs. Tori?
Yeah, some parents would say that students really are the forgotten group due to this pandemic. But new guidance issued by Governor Gavin Newsom is really giving parents like Sarah Smart hope for her special needs student tonight. 11-year-old Lila Matthew is a quadriplegic with cerebral palsy and dystonia.
So she has brain damage from birth.
Her mother, Sarah Smart, says for students like Lila, who depend on on-campus learning for a variety of reasons, distance learning is next to impossible.
They can't, you know, get on a computer and like expand their minds. They don't go to school, you know, to learn math or history or science or whatever it is. Like the main reason for her going to school is for like social interaction and like the speech therapy that she was getting on a weekly basis.
Lila was also in the MOVE program at Sequoia Middle School, where staff would help her out of her chair and practice body movements daily, giving her a break from her chair.
You know, school was what she lived for because it was something different than, you know, just being in the house all day.
Smart says Lila's teachers have been doing their absolute best to help her over Zoom, but it's not the same. She says it's also very difficult for her and makes things at home more tense for everyone. But in an effort to help parents like Smart, Governor Gavin Newsom released new cohort guidance this week for the specified subset of children like Lila. According to the California Department of Public Health, the new guidelines would allow for special needs students K through 12 to head back to campus in small groups no larger than 14 students with no more than two supervising adults. Staff would also be required to keep windows open and operate outside as much as possible, and they can work one-on-one with students as long as the staff member is not working in a larger group setting. Staff must also aim to stagger playground time to help prevent the spread of COVID-19. Staff and students would also all be required to wear a mask at all times. Now, we also reached out to the Kern County Public Health Department to see if they believe that the Kern County Superintendent of Schools can effectively and safely roll out this new guidance effectively, and we did not hear back as of news time. However, we did in fact confirm with the Kern County Superintendent of Schools that they are now looking into the new guidance to determine whether or not to roll it out and implement the new protocol. We will in fact bring you those details right here and on our website, turn to 23.com. Reporting live in Central Bakersfield, I'm Tori Cooper for 23 ABC News, connecting you.